Senator, let's talk about your legislation regarding sand frack mining and frack sand mining in the state of Wisconsin. Why do you think we need legislation to address the growing number of these mines?
The most frequent complaint that I hear from constituents is there's a sand mine going in my neighborhood and I didn't know anything about it. I want to be able to have a voice in what happens in my neighborhood. And the sand mine industry has been very good at finding places like unzoned townships or counties that have sort of a piecemeal approach to zoning and moving in and signing up contracts and land to open these sand mines with very little oversight. In some cases, we've had situations where a lot has happened within the county, but there's questions about whether or not the people that are making the decisions or on the county board are somehow in cahoots with the sand mine companies themselves. There was recently a big question of that with one particular member of the county board in Trumbull County.
Is it more of a siting concern on your part, or is it a health concern, or is it both?
It is. There are many concerns. One is the damage to the infrastructure with the roads. Another is the noise, the light pollution, the air pollution. Another big concern of my constituents is the drawing down of the aquifers. There are a lot of areas that have kind of sandy soil anyway. There are a lot of farms that use the water with high capacity drills. They use the water for cows, for cattle, for watering their crops. And now you have a very highly concentrated area that is using the water for washing the sand to sort it to send it out west for fracking. And there isn't the adequate ground monitoring that my constituents want in place to be able to make sure that when they turn their tap on, they're actually going to have water.
Would your legislation, in essence, sort of stop further growth in this industry? And I ask that because I've seen some of the critics of the legislation say there are provisions in there about siting that would mean, it's sort of like with wind turbines, mm-hmm. that you couldn't have a mine within a certain number of yards of a residence. That in effect, this would make expansion of the mining industry in the state almost impossible. What do you say to that?
That's absolutely not true. There are five different bills that I've introduced. Some of them have to do with people's right to know, to be involved, to have the knowledge when they buy property that there's a sand mine going in near them. The one that you mentioned that probably has caused the most consternation among the industry is a setback from a right. municipal area. And I would say to the sand mine industry, if you're willing to talk about this, and I have talked with them about it, let's come in and find some middle ground. If you don't like 2,500 feet, then how about 2,000? Definitely the bills have come from my constituents. These all represent concerns that the 195,000 people that I represent are telling me about. And I would say, without question, this is the number one issue people contact me about, and they are strongly opposed to the sand mines, those people that have called me.
And what's your response to those in the central and western and southwestern part of the state who say, this is jobs. We need jobs in some of these rural areas. We've been struggling. This is work. It is providing for our families. What do you say to them?
First of all, I think the sand mines need to be good neighbors. There is a balance that we can set, and there are mines that are doing a good job. Second of all, I have a whole lot of constituents that like to go into the parking lots and take pictures of all of the license plates from all different states that those employees are from.
So you're saying a lot of them are not Wisconsin people?
That's what I'm hearing from my constituents. And third, I have very many business owners up and down the Mississippi River who have spent their life savings starting a tourism business, and they're telling me that the mine in their neighborhood is incompatible with their tourism business, and they want to preserve Western Wisconsin and all of its beauty for the people that come from the cities and from the eastern part of the state to come and enjoy the beauty. Is there a balance? Like every legislative issue, of course there's a balance. But right now, we're tipping on the side of the sand mines and not so much on the side of the tourism industry in Western Wisconsin, let alone the constituents that are worried about what's happening next door that they don't have any voice in, or they feel they don't.
Senator Kathleen Vinehout, Democrat from Alma, thanks very much for being with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.